या यस
Okay. So yesterday we saw a brief introduction about the what is a class. So in Salesforce, in Apex, whatever code that we have to write inside our class. And you have to remember that you cannot call a class. In order to call or in order to do some functionality or in order to achieve something, you need to write a method. Okay. So in the class, we have to declare two members, two types of members. One is a member variable. Okay, one is a member variable, and then we have member function. Okay, so the members can be of two types. Okay, so the members are of two types. One is static members, and another is non-static members. Okay. So today we will see only the static members, non-static members, which is related to the objects that we will see later. Okay. So for static members, you have to remember that static is something which is connected to class. Okay. The whole class. It is not connected to the object. The non-static ones are the ones which is connected to objects that we will be creating using the new keyword. This we will see later. As of now, we will be seeing about the static members, the static variable, static function. Okay, these things we will be seeing. Okay, and this what I have written, this is a single line comment. Okay, if you give double slash, whatever you write after that, that is considered as a comment. And that's a single line comment. If you write something after this, this is not considered as a comment. This it will compile and this it will detect. Okay, whatever you write after the comment, after the double slashes, the compiler will ignore that. And that is not considered as a part of the code. Okay. So, member variables. What are member variables? Member variables are the placeholders in which if you have to save any data for this particular class, if you need some kind of data for this particular class to work, then you have to declare variables. Okay, so variables are also of two types. One is a global variable and one is a local variable. So whatever you declare right inside the class, right under the parent class, that is a global variable. Why it's called global variable? Okay, so let me write it as global and one is local. Okay, so global variables are global throughout the class. That means if you declare a global variable, then you can use it from anywhere within the class. Okay, local variables will be local to some scope. Either it will be local to our method or it will local to some parenthesis. So if it's local, then you can use it only inside that scope. Okay, that example also I will give. Okay, so let's try to declare some member variables and we will try to use it. So the first thing that we need to know is static. Static is something which is related to class. So if you declare a class and if you declare some member variables as static, that means that is unique throughout the class and you have to use it with the class name. So you can access that variable and you can access that members from outside the class also using the class name. Okay, if you declare it as public, obviously. Okay, so to declare a variable, first thing that you need to do, if you want it to be as public or want it to be accessible from outside the class also, then you declare it as public. And to declare it as static, you use the keyword static. Okay, public static, and then you declare the data type. What is the type of data that variable is going to hold? So type of data that we want to let's say we want string to be held. Okay, public static string, then we'll give something like maybe first name. Okay, so this is declaration of a variable that we have declared and it is a static variable that we have declared. Okay, so if you want some more strings to be added, you can add some more strings right here also, like last name also you can write here. Okay, and if you need some kind of integer, then you have to declare something like public static integer, maybe count, or you can say limit. Okay, So this is a another variable. So like this, you can declare any number of variables with the data type. If you want to create some accounts, or if you need some variable to hold account or opportunity. No one is able to hear me. Harsh, Bala.
I can hear you, Mustafa. Mustan here.
Okay. Okay, before moving ahead, let's also take a look into some details about limit. What is a keyword and what is a not, what's not a keyword? String line. Okay. Here we have just declared two string variables, which is able to hold some string data. Okay, that's it. And here we have also used a static keyword. So static means that this belongs to the class. This does not belong to any object. This will be unique throughout the class.
Okay.
So another thing we need to know about declaring a variable or declaring a member function is keyword and literal. Okay. So keywords are the reserved words, like public, static. These have specific meaning throughout the Apex class. Okay, if you write public, then it understands that yes, it should be public, it should be accessible from outside the class also. So this public keyword is reserved for some purpose. Okay, so the words that you write which has some meaning already defined, those are called keywords, like class. Class is also a keyword. Okay, similar to that, see, there are things that you, so the keywords you have to use only for the specific purpose. Now you cannot use the keywords to define a variable. Like you cannot name the variable as the keyword. So you cannot name any variable public. Okay, if you see, it's highlighted in a different color. So it means that this public, this is a keyword, this is reserved for some purpose. See, unexpected token is showing public. You cannot name any variable or any member function with any keyword. You have to name it with something called literal. Okay, so what's a literal? Literal is the name that we give. So we have given here first name, last name. So whatever name that we define, those are called literals. Okay, this point is clear. Like keywords, it is reserved for some specific purpose. You cannot use keywords to name any variable or any member function. Okay. Okay. All right, moving ahead. So if I have declared the only three variables, so two variables are of string type, one variable is of integer type. Okay. Okay, so these are all global variables. So if you declare, so let's try to create some member functions. Okay, so to declare a function, so here also we'll have to give an access specifier, whether it's public or whether it's private. Okay, if we don't give anything, then it will become private. So here also, if we don't give any public here, then by default this will become private. Okay, these variables are private. So what does that mean? That means that outside the class we will not be able to access it. Okay, we won't be able to access it. So let me make it as public. Okay, and if I try to give first name as, let's say, okay, and last name I'll give as, says. Okay. So as it's a string, so string has to take something which is under quotes. Okay, so string is a collection of characters. Okay, so if you write whatever you write inside that these two quotes, it will be considered as string. So you can write anything. So that will be considered as string because it's still under quotes. Okay. Okay, and let me give some integer also. So if I give here, let's say 10. Okay, so what does this public mean? That means it is accessible also from outside that class. How can we see that? So there is something called anonymous window. So we can go to the anonymous window, and from here we can execute some small codes. We can call our methods, or we can call our functions, or we can call, or you can use these variables also. So this class scope ends from here to here. You see these two are highlighted as green. So the scope of the class is ending here. So if I want to use this variable outside this class, as it's a static, I can use it using the class name. Okay, so I can access, how can I access these two, these three variables from outside the class? Using the class name. So my class name is first demo class, and after that I have to put a dot notation, and then I have to use the name of the variable which I want to access. So I can say first name. See, it's already highlighting that. Okay, so I can use that first name. Okay, so like this we can access this variable. But right now I have written this variable, but it's of no meaning. What do I want to do with this? That I have not declared. So let us say if I want to print the value of this variable. So for that, how do I do? I have a class called system, and I have to do a debug. Okay, system.debug, and in this I'll write the name of the variable that I want to access. So first I need to write the name of the class which the variable belongs to, first demo class, and then I give a dot notation, then I give first name. Okay, now if I execute this from the anonymous window, now it will give me the value of this first name. So whatever was the value of the first name, that it will show me here. Okay, it's printing that same thing. So debug log is mostly to do any kind of debug, and it is used to find out errors most of the times. That we will see later how to use debug logs. Okay, so as of now you just have to understand that we are able to access the variable from outside the class because it is declared as public. Okay, now if you remove this as to be not public, then by default it becomes private. By default all the variables are private as you have not specified anything. Now if you save and you try to access, it must throw us an error that it is not visible. Okay, so now if I execute this, see, the variable is not visible. That means it is not able to see that variable. Why it's not able to see? Because it is not a public. So by default it is private. Okay, so you can also manually specify it as private. If you manually also specify it as private, and then you save it, and then you try to execute, again it will throw us the same error that it is not visible. So the variable is not visible because the scope of private ends from here to here. It ends here. Outside this, if you try to access, it will not be accessible. Okay, so that's the use of the access specifier, private, public, and you also have global. That is mostly for outside the org. So yes, we are, yes. Okay, and in this debug system.debug function, okay, whatever you write inside this, that is converted into string. Okay, it is converted into string and it is displayed. Okay, how does it know that what to display? Right now I have used the variable name. So whatever the value is inside the variable, it will convert that into a string and it will display. Okay, similar to that, if I want to display some characters also, let's say I want to display something like hello there. Okay, so I have to give it a string. It must be convertible to a string always, the system.debug. Okay, it will display me that string type. Okay, I go to debug only, and here it will be displayed. Okay, so this thing will be converted to a string and it will be displayed. So if I want to add something to it, so the in string we have a plus symbol which is called a concatenation operator. Okay, so plus symbol, if you use this plus symbol with two strings, then it will concatenate. That means it will combine those two strings together. Okay, and if you use it for numbers, then it will add those numbers. It will do the addition of those numbers. Okay, so if you use it with two strings, let us say I have two strings here, Hari, first name and last name, I have two strings. Okay, so if I combine those two strings, let's say system.debug, and if I if I access first name directly, okay, and then I say plus last name, okay, then let's see what we get. So if I execute this, so it says that variable does not exist. Why does it say variable does not exist first name? Because this variable doesn't mean anything. It's here I have not declared any variable with first name. I have declared a variable inside this class, and that too it's a static. That means this variable belongs to this class. So in order to access that variable, I have to use the name of the class first. So I have to say first demo class dot first name. Okay, now this variable will be visible. Okay, now if I execute again, it will throw me the same error that last name variable also does not exist. So here also I have to give the class name. Okay. So now I will be able to execute this. Okay. So it has concatenated both of them. So first name and last name is getting together. Okay. So this plus operator now concatenated two strings, as this also contains strings, this also contains string. But if I use it with some kind of integer, then it will add. Okay. If I do system.debug, and then if I add, let's say 20 plus, I have my variable also declared here. So this variable I can use, which is limit one. Okay. Let me add this. So if I use limit one, okay, I have to give my name also, name of the class also, dot limit one. Then if I execute, okay, now it has added those two numbers. Okay, so if it finds two integers, then it will add those two integers, and then it will convert that to string, and it will display it here. Here also it is converted to string and it is displayed here. Okay, so if I want to add something more to it, all I have to do is use the plus operator and put whatever I want to add in the single quotes. Okay, let's say if I want to give some space here, or I want to say something like maybe first name. So if okay, let me try to give some space. So if I want to give one, see, if you see these two, first name and last name both are together, and we are not able to distinguish these two. So if I want to add some space, then I have to give one space here. That's it. Okay. Now if I execute, there will be one space included. So like that, if you want to include some strings or you want to add some strings, you can also do. Now if you see, there's some space here. Okay. So if I want to give something like, maybe you can say first name equals to, then you do a plus. Then here you can say something like last name equals to. Okay. So I have included some more string. This is something that I have typed, and this is something which is coming from the class. First name and last name, this is coming from the class. Okay. Let me just comment this line. Okay. And also this line, not required as of now. So as I have commented, these will be not considered for execution. Okay, the compiler will ignore these two lines. Okay, now if I execute, only that line will be, the second line will be executed, and it will include whatever we have written inside my debug log. Okay, now it is showing first name is equal to Hari and last name equals to Sarah. Okay, so what are we doing here using the plus symbol? This is called concatenation. Okay, and what we are doing here in the bottom, in the last line here, that is addition. Okay, because we are using integers. So if you use integers, that will be added. If you use string, that will be concatenated. Okay, so this is the dynamic behavior of the plus symbol. Okay, this point is clear, everybody. Yes? No? Maybe?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. So we saw some member variables. Let me just close out of all these things. So this you have to keep in mind that these are static member variables. Okay. Non-static things we'll see later. As of now, you just concentrate on the static things. So static variables or static members can be accessed using the class name. Class name dot the name of the variable. That is how you can access from outside the class. But if you want to access from within the class, then you can just directly access them with the name, because they are visible. Okay, from outside the class, it's not visible. So you are specifying the name of the class and then you are making it visible. Okay. Okay, now let's try to create some member functions. Okay, so how to declare a function? So first we have to give an access specifier, just like naming a variable. Here we have given public or a private. So similar to that, we can also specify here public. And then we want to make it a part of the class. We want to use a static member, so we have to call it as static also. Okay, now we have to define what is the return type of the method. So if you call that method, what will be returned? What is the output that you will get from the method? So that return type, as of now, I don't want to return anything, so I'll keep it void. Okay, now I have to say the name of the method. So I want to call it maybe print name. Okay. And inside this method, what logic I want to do? I just want to display something. Okay, so I can say something like system.debug, and then I can say first name equals to plus first name, then I add another, then I give space last name equals to, then I add last. Okay, so what is the functionality that I want to achieve using this method? I just want to display something, display the variables, whatever is contained in these two variables. Okay, so whenever I call, so to execute this method, I have to call this method. It is not going to execute on its own. I have to call this method. Whenever I call this method, that is how it will be achieving the functionality that we have written inside it. Okay, so this is how you declare the function. So to declare the function, you write the access specifier, then you give whether you want it to be static or non-static, then you declare the return type of the method, and then you give the name of the method. Okay, so right now this method is not taking any input, it is just displaying something, it is just showing us output, and it is not returning anything also. That means it is not doing any calculation and it's not returning any value. It will just display this. That's it. Okay, so how do we call this method? So if we are calling this method somewhere inside the class, then we just use the name of the method and use the two brackets, something like this. So if I say print name, so this is how I call the method. Simple. You just write the name of the method and you write two brackets. Okay, this method will be called. Okay, as of now, I cannot call this from inside the class. I have to, all the logic that I have to write inside the method. Some method I have to write. Okay, and also this is also forbidden, that you cannot call the function of the same method from within the same method. Then it will become recursion. Okay, which is an infinite loop and which will end the execution with an exception. So you cannot call the same method from within the method. So you cannot call something like this. Okay, this will again become an exception. This is a runtime error. Okay, so if you run this, it will become a problem and it will keep on executing. This is an exception. Okay, so as of now, we will not get into that. So we have created a method which does just print something. It doesn't give any output. It does not return us anything, any value, as it's declared as void. That means it is not returning us anything. It is just printing it. So how do I call this method from outside the class? So I go to my anonymous window. Okay, and from here I just have to call that method. So how do I call that method? If I call that method something like print name. Now if I try to execute this part, and if you see here, there are two buttons here. One is execute and one is execute highlighted. So if I say execute highlighted, it will only execute the thing that I have highlighted or I have selected. If I click on execute, then it will execute all the lines. Okay, so I want only this line to be executed. So I'm clicking on execute highlighted. So now if I execute this, it will throw us an error. The method does not exist. Okay, why it says the method does not exist? Because it doesn't exist inside this anonymous window. as it is part of the member of the class, then and also it's a static, so I have to use the name of the class. So I have to use first name of class dot the name of the method. Okay, now if I call this, now it will be executed. And what it will do, it will just show me the result. It will just print something. It is not returning anything as of now. Okay, so whatever I have written inside the method, that is getting displayed. Okay, which is similar to our previous. Okay, so this is a void method. This is a void method. That means it doesn't return. So let's say, and this also doesn't take any input. So if you have to, yes, you can define. So okay, fine, we can see the local variable now. Now we can see the local variable. So let us say if I want to create a variable. Okay, if I declare any variable inside this class, let's say I want to create a boolean, let's say flag. Okay, and if I say it as true, so boolean is a data type which will take two types of value only, true or false. It can only be true or false. If you give anything else, it will not accept. You cannot write integer or string or anything else inside this. Boolean always will take true or false, so it can have only two values. Okay, that is another data type. So here I have declared a variable called flag. It's not a keyword, so that is fine. I can declare a variable with this name. Okay, and as it's a boolean, the data type should be either true or false. Okay, so now I have created a variable. If I want to use it, I can use that also. I can access that variable system.debug. I can say value of flag is, then I can say flag. Okay, so this is totally permissible because right now this is a local variable and this is accessible from within the method. So if you want to access this from somewhere outside the method, then it is not accessible because it is local to this particular method. Okay, so now outside this method, if you want to declare some another boolean, let's say boolean flag value, you want to check what is the value of the flag and you want to assign it to another variable. So you have created another variable, and what value you will assign, you will assign the value of this flag. Okay, so let us try to run this. So it is not saving and it says that variable does not exist flag. So why variable does not exist? Because this flag variable exists only from this scope to this scope. If you use it from outside this, it is not accessible because this is a local variable. Okay, so local variables can be used within the scope, of the parameters that it is defined. Okay, you cannot use it from outside. You can't even call it from anonymous window or anywhere, any other class. You can't do that because it is local and it is defined, it is designed only for this. Okay, now if you create another variable with the same name outside the class, it is totally permissible. Sorry, what, anyone ask me any question? Hello? Okay. Does anyone have any question? No? Not audible. Okay, as you can see, it is throwing us an error that variable does not exist. That means this is a local variable. Okay, so it exists only within the scope of that particular method. Okay. See, I've just created a variable. ठीक है. सो हाउ डज इट बिकम अ लोकल वेरिएबल? इफ आई डिक्लेयर इट फ्रॉम अ क्लास, इफ आई डिक्लेयर इट इनसाइड एनी क्लास, इट बिकम्स लोकल टू दैट. सॉरी, इफ आई डिक्लेयर इट इनसाइड द क्लास, देन इट बिकम्स ग्लोबल, लाइक डायरेक्टली इनसाइड द क्लास, नॉट इनसाइड एनी अदर मेथड. सो इफ आई डिक्लेयर, so if I declare it inside the method, then it becomes local to that method.
Basically, what I
okay. So here I've just created a method which is Boolean data type and which takes true value, so it becomes local. Okay, if I try to access this from anywhere outside this method, it is not accessible.
Okay.
So if I try to access this from somewhere here, it will throw me an error that this flag variable does not exist. Because it is
it should protected. Be
so,
so
yeah.
Early, I mean, I knew the problem for the earlier. I
okay.
Earlier, how it goes
nowadays. Okay. But earlier we. Okay. So now let's see how to provide any input. If you want to provide this method with any input, then how do you give inputs? So you give inputs from parameters. So the parameters that you pass in this particular method, that will be the input to that particular method. Okay, so let's declare another method. So I can say maybe public static, and as of now I don't want to return anything, so I want it to be void only. Okay, and then I can say maybe dynamic method. And how do I pass inputs? So I pass inputs using this parameter, and I have to declare some variable which accept those parameters. So I can declare, let's say, I can get some string only. Okay, I'll take some string input. Let's say string fn and string ln. Okay, and I want to. Okay, so I am taking two inputs, both of them are string. Okay, one, so these variables that I defined here, string fn and string ln, these two variables are also local variables. They are only accessible from within this method, as I've defined within the method. So if I try to access this fn and ln from outside the method, it is not accessible. Okay, so this is also, these are also local variables. Okay, so what I want to do is I will be providing input from outside this class to this method, and I will be assigning these two values to this first name and last name. Okay, so I'll say something like I'll do a debug log, system.debug. I can say something like before assignment. Of values. Okay, so this is before assignment of values. Now I will try to read the values. What are the values of these variables? Let's try to check out those values. Okay, so value of first name equals to, I'll add and I'll say first name. Okay, then again I will add, I'll say last name equals to, then I can say last name. Okay, so this I am reading the values before I am trying to assign whatever input is given to these two variables. Okay, this is before assignment, so I have given a comment before assignment. Okay, now I will try to assign some values. So I can write some comment just to explain assign dynamic values. Why I'm using dynamic values? Because this value will be not declared inside the class. This is coming from outside the class. If somebody provides us an input with first name and last name, I will assign those two values to this first name variable and last name variable. Okay, so this is like dynamically assigning values. Okay, so how do I assign the values? I just say first name equals to fn. Okay, so whatever input is provided inside the fn, whatever value somebody gives inside fn, that I will assign to my first name. And first name is the class member, variable. Okay, so Hari, initially it was saving Hari. Now Hari will be removed, and whatever input somebody provides from outside, that will be added in that variable. So variable is just like a placeholder. Okay. So if I declare string first name equals to Hari, or if I just say string first name, so it will just create a box, and that will be named as first name. It will be first. Excuse my handwriting, please. I hope it is clear that it is first name. So it is a first name box, and in this it will always contain string. So here as of now it will contain Hari. It will contain Hari. Okay. So in this line here, I have said that first name equals to fn. So whenever I call this method, I have to give these two inputs, and if I give input to fn, that fn, whatever value is there, that will be saved in this variable. Okay, not here, it will not be saved here, it will be saved here in this last line. I'm just saving the value. Okay, so let us see that in action. How does it happen? Okay, so I have assigned first name equals to fn, and I also have to give last name equals to ln. Okay, now we will try to debug, and we will try to see what is the value which is contained after the assignment. So I'll say something like system.debug after, or we can say values, values after assignment. Okay, then I can do on system.debug, and I can say value, or I can just copy this thing. Okay, now let us try to call this second method from outside the class. Okay, so if I go to my anonymous window, and if I try to, I will remove all these things. Okay, and if I want to call this method dynamic method. Okay, so whenever I call this method, I have to provide input. I must provide input because it is supposed to take two parameters. So I must provide two parameters, and those two parameter data type must match whatever data type I have declared here. So here I have declared string. Here this is also string. So I have to provide two string inputs if I want to call that method. If I don't provide, it will not execute at all. Okay, so I have to provide two methods. So I can say something like say one input as Harsh and one input as, let's say, Bal. Okay, so this is how I'll be calling this method. So I must provide two inputs to this method, as one input will, this Harsh will be saved inside fn, and this Bala will be saved inside ln. Okay, and coming down to this line, first name will be taking the value of fn. So fn contains what? Fn contains Harsh. So Harsh will go inside fn. So this assignment is always from right to left. Okay, right side of the equals operator. So from the right, it will go to left. It will always go from right to left. Okay, it will never go reverse. The first name will never be assigned to fn. Okay, it always goes from right side to left side. Okay, so as here also you can see boolean flag equals to true. So from right side true, it will go to flag. Okay, it always has to go from right. Okay, so let us try to call this method. So if I call this method again, it will throw me an error. Why? Because this method is not visible. This method is visible only from within the class. If I want to access from outside the class, then I have to use the class name. Right now, this execution, this anonymous window doesn't know what is dynamic method. I have declared this inside some class, but it is not aware of this class. So to make this this anonymous window aware of this particular method, I have to show him the path. Okay, show the path, like where it has to go. So for example, if I go to my Explorer, if I go to my Windows Explorer, okay, and if I try to, this computer has some path, right? C, colon, all those things are there. So if I just give something like desktop, okay, it will not go. It doesn't find that path. Okay, that is not possible. But if I go to my desktop here, so if I see, it is not showing the path. So it is, see, these paths and all. So if I give document directly, it will not go to document. So I have to declare the path, users and this folder name, then this document it will go to. Similarly, if I use just the method name here, where did I go? So if I use a method name, it doesn't know what this method or where it belongs to. Okay, if I execute this, it will show that this method does not exist. So in order to access this method, I have to declare which class it belongs to. So I have to also show first name. Oops, not this. So I have to use first. What is my name of the class? First demo class. Then use a dot operator. I'm using dot because it's all static. That means you can access it with the name of the class. Okay, so now if I see, I'm passing these two dynamic inputs from outside the class. Okay, now if I execute this, the value we will be seeing. Okay, now if I go to my debug only, so if I see before assignment of the value of first name was Hari and the value of last name was this. Okay, now after the assignment of values, after the assignment, value of first name becomes Harsh and the value of last name becomes Bala. So where is this input coming from? This value is coming from outside the class. So this is how you provide input to a method. Okay, this is how you will provide input to this method. Okay, and if you miss out any of the inputs, okay, so again it will show that this method does not exist. Okay, now if I execute this, this method does not exist because it is incorrect signature. So what is the signature? Signature is whatever you write from this void to the end of the parameter. This whole thing is signature. Okay, this whole thing is signature. So while declaring the method, you give a signature and the same signature must be followed when you call that method. Okay, so if that particular method is supposed to receive two parameters, then you must provide two parameters while calling the method. Okay, and as this method is not returning anything, so we are not using any variable to save that value because it is returning null. It is not returning anything. Not even null. It's not even returning null. It's not returning anything. Okay, so here also we have to match the signature. Okay, while calling also. So we have to match the parameters also. Okay, so we must provide two inputs here. Okay, this is how we are matching the parameter. So similarly, if you want to call this method, the first name also, this also you have to match the signature. Dot print. Okay, this is how you'll be calling those two methods. Okay, now if I execute this, this will be executed fine. So both the methods are executed. Okay, one is receiving parameters, one is not receiving parameters. So this does not receive any input, this receives two inputs. Okay, this is how you receive input from any give any input to any method. Now how do you receive any output from the method? So for the output you need something called return type. Okay, right now if you see this method, this doesn't receive anything because it is void. I mean, this doesn't return anything because both of them are void. Void means the return type is nothing, it will not return anything. So if you want the methods to return something, then you have to give a return type and you also have to give a return statement in the end. So you can say something like public. I'll just show small example and then we'll wind off. Okay, we'll say public static and then we'll say return type. Now we have to give a return type. So what should be the return type? I have to give a string return type. Let's say I want to return string. I want to return first name and last name. Okay, and you also have to keep in mind that one method is capable of returning only one value. It can return only one thing. It can return any object, it can return S object, it can return any data type, string, integer, boolean, everything, but it can return only one value. Okay, you cannot declare like multiple things here like string, integer, so like return two things like that. You cannot do that. So you have to return only one value, either string or integer or whatever. Okay, so public static. Now we give the name of the value, name of the method. Let's say we can say maybe IO, input output method. Okay, and now it has to receive some parameters also. So let me see, I can give multiple parameters also. I can take three parameters also. I can take one parameter for this limit one also. Okay, so for that also I have to declare the data type of that local variable first. So I can say something like maybe string fn and string ln, and then I can say boolean lmt something. Okay, and you have to notice this, that this fn is different, this fn is different, this fn scope starts from here and ends here. It is not, it does not exist outside this. So outside this you can use the same name, it will not complicate, it will not conflict. Okay, this is different and this is different. This fn scope is also starting from here and it's ending here because it's a local. So if you declare fn here at the top, then there will be a confusion, then we have to figure it out. Okay, that also I'll show you how to do that. Okay, as of now today we don't have much time, so let me just check this out. Okay, so now this is supposed to return supposed to take three inputs. One is a string, both two are string, and one is boolean. Okay, and if you see, it means it's showing me a problem, that it's showing me that return statement is missing. Why return statement is missing? Because I have given a return type a string. So as it's a string return type, that means this method must return a string value. If I don't give a return statement, it will not save it. Okay, so I must return the value. Okay, so okay, I'll not use the boolean as of now. Okay, fine, I'll just display the boolean, I'll not put any if condition or something. Then you guys will, we have not covered that topic, so we cannot go there as of now. Okay, so I'll just display the value system.debug, and I will display value of boolean variable lmt equals to, I can say just plus lmt. Okay, that is the purpose of this variable. I will not assign this variable here because I'll have to use an if condition, and you guys will not understand. Okay, now I will use the same thing from here to there. So I'll just assign these two values. Okay, no, this method is supposed to return something, right? So what I'm going to do is I am going to return fn plus ln. Okay, so I'm just concatenating both two. I am adding first name and last name. Okay, and then I'm just returning it. So now it's returning the string. Okay, it's not adding, it's not addition, this is concatenation. Okay, so concatenation of one two strings will all obviously be string only. So I'm returning a string. So this return statement is matching the return statement that I've declared here. So I have to return a string, so I'm returning a string. So if I return something like something else, if I return lmt, lmt is what? Lmt is a boolean. So if I return boolean, it will throw me an error. Okay, because I've declared a string type of return, I cannot, it's trying to convert it. It's trying to convert this lmt boolean into string, which is not possible. So it is showing my illegal conversion from boolean to string. Okay, so I will revert it back. Now I'm returning a string. So it is returning fn plus ln. Okay, so now let me save it. Okay, so if I save it, now this method is fine, it should be functional. And if I try to execute this, if I call this method from outside the class, so I have to give the, first I have to give the name of the class. Okay, so I have to give the name of the class first demo class dot io method. Okay, and now I cannot run this because I have to provide some inputs to this method. Okay, so this input I have to give two variables, two string values. I can give, let's say, I can give Sudha, and then I can give comma, maybe I can give Reddy. Okay, and then I have to give one boolean value. So one boolean value I have to give, let's say I'll give true or I'll give false. Okay, now still there is something wrong with this code, because I have to return string. Right now I have not used quotes here, so it will be trying to check it as a variable. It will try to look for that variable and it will not be able to find. So if I have to declare it as string, I have to return as I have to take input as string, I have to give quotes. Okay, now it is considered a string. So if I similar for this, so now this is considered a string. Okay, so now I am calling this method, but this method is supposed to return something. So if it is supposed to return something, then I have to catch that value also. Okay, if I try to execute this, let's try to execute. Okay, so right now it has executed and it is only showing me the false value. Okay, I'm not able to use whatever it is trying to return. So to use something that it is returning, I have to catch it somewhere in some variable. Okay, so to catch that, I have to either give another variable or I can write it inside the a debug statement also. Okay, so I can declare a variable first. So I can say something like string. So as the value that is trying to return, that is a string return type only. That is string only. It is trying to return a string value only. So I have to catch that using a string variable only. Okay. So return value. I can say a variable called return value. And what is the return value? How do I use the return value? I have to copy this thing. I have to write it inside this. Okay. So now the return value variable will contain whatever this method is returning. So it is going to call that method and it is providing three inputs. It will give those inputs to the method here, and then whatever the method returns, it will fetch and it will save that value inside the return value variable. Okay, that much work is done in this one line of code. Okay, so what does the return value contain? That I can check it out here. Let's say I'll go a system.debug. I can say return value equals to, and then I can give the variable name plus return value. Okay, now if I execute these two lines, let me execute this highlighted part. Okay, so that first statement is also coming. That first statement is coming because whenever that method is called, that first statement will be, it's a debug log. So whenever I call, so here from this statement, what is happening? I'm calling this method. So this method is called, it comes here, it comes, oh, let me remove this. It comes here, all the three inputs are copied. Okay, Sudha is copied to Fn, Reddy is copied to Ln, and the false is copied to LMT. All those are copied here, then it comes inside the first statement system.debug. So the first statement system.debug is shown here also. Okay, so system.debug is shown and the value of LMT is false. That means the value that I am passing from here, false, that is getting copied to LMT, and LMT value is showing false. Okay, and now the return value is, what is it returning? It's just adding first name and last name. It's just adding those two variables, Fn and Ln, and it is returning. So that is why the return, whatever it's showing, that is also Sudha plus Reddy. So it is just adding it and it is returning here. Okay. So I'm just adding Fn and Ln. Fn is what? Sudha. Ln is what? Reddy. So it is just returning it. So as I'm returning, so that return value, so Sudha Reddy is contained in this return value. This return variable will contain Sudha plus Reddy. Okay, and I'm just trying to display the value here. So when I display the value, so return value, it will show Sudha Reddy. Okay. Now let me say if I want to add some space also here. So you can say something like this. So I'll give one space. Now if I save this. Now if I execute this. Okay, so now the return value becomes Sudha space Reddy. Yes, exactly. So the return value is just like a reference value. It's just a temporary variable that I have used to display something. I could have directly also written this whole thing inside the debug log also. I can also do something like this. I can say system.debug and I can directly write this whole method call from inside. So how do I call my method? The first thing I have to use is the name of the class. So first name, then first demo class. Demo class, then I give a dot and then I give IO method. Okay, then I have to provide some inputs. So I have to give, let's say I give sampa, then I give second parameter as, let's say, and the third parameter as true, let's say. Okay, I can also directly call it from inside. Now if I execute, this will also work fine. So if I execute the highlighted part, this will also give me the same result. Okay, this also gives me the same result. So this was just a temporary variable which I've created just to access it here so that you guys can understand. I can also do directly like this also. Okay, does that answer your question, Mala?
Yes.
When calling, what do you say? Calling that method, won't that display the fn ln values mentioned in the return command? No, it will not. It will not display directly because it will try to, first it will try to what you call inside the bracket, it will try to execute it. It will not directly convert it. If I have written something like in quotes, then it will just make it as a string and display whatever is inside the quotes. Okay, right now from here I'm calling the method. This is a method call. This statement from here to here, this is a call of the method. So I'm calling that method. It will not display directly the values. It will not display anything actually. It will just call that method. So it is going to call these methods. Those parameters.
No,
will...
line.
Yeah.
On the anonymous window, line 3, we are calling that method, right?
Line 3, this one?
So there we are providing the input, right? Sudha Reddy false.
Huh.
And calling that method, it will go to that method and execute what is in there, right?
So yes, correct.
They have done F1 concatenating the space plus L1.
Huh.
So won't that take the values directly from here and display? Or?
This is going to return. This is going to return value, but nobody is here to catch that value, right?
Okay.
It will return fn plus ln. That it will do, but nobody is here. No variable is here to catch it, or no debug statement is there to catch it. Okay. So okay. Here I'm just catching that value using another variable. Okay. So whatever this method is returning, that is caught by this variable, and this variable I'm displaying it here.
Okay.
So in this third statement, in this last line, I'm not catching it in anywhere. Whatever it is returning, I'm just displaying it directly.
Okay.
Okay. Is that what you wanted to ask?
Okay. Yeah, correct. Yeah, correct.
Yeah. Okay. I think we are already 10 minutes ahead of our time. Okay. Anybody, any questions, any doubts?